Kalkıp anda. Kalkı. Hadi kalk. Kalka. So. Kalka. What's that?
I'm telling
you,
how's
it working? Very well. So, your cooling system. No longer an issue.
No, no, no.
That one is
fixed. Of late. This one, sometimes it seizes. Low. That's the one on the left. I noticed this one only comes on when it's on high speed or AC.
One of the fans?
Yes. One of it is now, it seizes.
Okay.
So I checked it, I think it was a fuse problem.
Okay.
Well, I'll fix it now, it's working fine, but how come that I don't have any issue with the cooling system?
So, but the other one, have you confirmed that the issue is not, as in, that it has been fixed permanently?
The fan?
I'm talking about the map sensor. Have you done scanning since then? Have you scanned the car since that time?
No, I've not scanned the car since the last time it's coming.
There seems to be sure that.
Because that, you know that day we checked, last time we checked, before. What do you call it? It was not communicating when we checked the values.
Okay.
It was not communicating. The values were too high.
Yeah.
That was what we concluded.
Okay. It's going to take a lot of time, man, because all I need to do, like I told you on the phone, have to check, first confirm that it's still not working on my diagnostic tool.
Okay.
Then the next thing I'll do is to remove all the engine wiring harness, then start from that socket, the map sensor socket, and then check the continuity.
Okay.
To be sure there's no discommunication between the engine ECU
and the
map sensor. Then the ground supply. It also has a ground supply. Be sure that the ground supply is still connected. Probably, I will check if there's a fuse that also powers it.
Okay.
But I don't think there's any fuse that will power just one sensor.
Okay.
So it's supposed to be. Because it means if there's a fuse that powers the map sensor and the fuse that blows, it means other sensor, other components or gadget that that fuse powers will also not be working. So in your case, I don't think it's a fuse issue. It's either between the engine wiring harness or the engine ECU. So that's what I'm going to do on this car. It's going to be a lot of work.
So one of my
mechanics was okay. Yeah, I forgot. Originally it was automatic.
It was automatic, yes.
It's still connected.
Do I still need the two ECUs?
Nope.
I just need the new one.
I can disconnect the transmission ECU.
Okay.
Unless I think a few cases I've had people disconnected it and started warning them of automatic transmission fault.
Okay.
You know, they don't want to be seeing that fault on the instrument panel.
Okay.
Other than that, you can disconnect it.
I'm just to confirm for you before I disconnect it.
No, you don't need it. Okay. Don't need it. We'll do a test before you go. We'll disconnect it and see what happens. So I don't know how long, like I told you, I don't know how long this one's going to take. I guess I have to strip the entire wire and start tracing it. But we'll see how far it goes anyway.
Okay.
When the work starts. All right.